No worries. I expected one question from all of you. Yesterday, we integrated two plugins on Google Docs. We used only one. What about the second one? What about the second one? Two add-ins. Yesterday, we had integrated two add-ins. One is Attributify. We used only Attributify. And the second one is? Not input tools. You please open open a Google Doc and a new tab. CC license chooser. What's the second one? Attributify and CC. Please all of you open your Google Docs. And open your OER. I think you need to log in using a second browser. Use a second browser. You go to Firefox. You go to Firefox and log in. So please start a screencast automatic. Start recording. Yes. And start record. So please all of you go to your Google Docs and open yesterday's OER document. docs.google.com. Okay. So what's the second add-on? Yeah. So we didn't choose that. We didn't use that. So then no one asked me that question. Okay, this is actually. And the other question I expected from you all, how do I share my content as OER? No one asked me. Okay, so these two questions are related. What we'll do is, generally we do without using this add-on. All of you please open a new tab. Open a new tab. Tab. And go to creativecommons.org/choose. This is for creating your own org/choose, choose. So by default we get CC BY here. So under what terms and conditions you would like to release your content as OER. So yesterday we learnt about CC BY, CC BY SA, CC BY NC, CC BY ND, all this. See, by default this is S for everything. You just scroll down. So it's the most open license. How many of you need to follow your where is Professor Fong? Dr. Kenneth, you need to follow your university's OER policy, or they can use their own policy for sharing their content. So NC is there. What's your license? NC, yeah? Yesterday we saw that. Can you just open this NC, yeah? So you need to change all these then. So what is the condition? Then you need to, yeah, check. No. Then this is the license you have. No, this is NC only. See, this is the non-commercial, NC only. These all are the icons. Seriously, everyone said no, this is your license only. Okay, so what you need to, in two ways we can do. So simply copying this, just scroll down. Please all of you open your PPT, in blank PPT. Okay, you open a PPT here. It's already there, you open a blank PPT. Assuming that this is your first slide, and you obviously you'll have your title of your presentation and your name and everything. So what we do is we'll go to that Creative Commons license chooser. I think you are on Firefox. So you copy this part from here, this icon. Select this part icon till here. No, copy this, drag and drop. Yes. You drag you place it here, and from here to you drag it. Not that one, only this part. Yes, you copy this part and come back to your PPT and just control V. No need to place your cursor, just control V, that's it. Yeah, you can drag and drop either to the bottom or just adjust that. I think no. Control Z? No, Control Z twice. Yeah, you click outside first. Yeah, now you can select these two. Using Shift or Control, you can select these two. No. Select one first, then the second one. Then Control or Shift with Shift. The box itself, the license box itself. Okay, drag these two to the down and align these to left. You can delete this. Just align these to left. Delete those two. That's it. Yeah, bottom one. Yeah, that you can delete that box itself. Text box itself, you delete the box. Top one. We have already copied. Yeah. You adjust this layout to the left. Select these two and drag towards left. Okay. Any queries on this? So, we are following your university's OER policy. As per the policy, this is CC BY-NC, Creative Commons Attribution Non-Commercial 4.0. This is the latest version. Any queries on this? Now go to Creative Commons. Show me that creativecommons.org. Yeah, go to creativecommons.org/choose. You copy that and better paste on PPT. I think it's not visible. Open a second slide and control and M. Yeah, paste it here. Yeah, see. So, if you want to share your content as open educational resources, anyway, some of you have initiated the MOOCs. So, better you share your content under OER. For that, we are following your university's open license, that is CC BY-NC. You go there and again redemonstrate that. Yeah, so by default, refresh the page, refresh. By default, we have, just to scroll down. Yeah, by default, this is CC BY license. Means, users can do anything with your content. But as per your policy, we need to check this, no. Is it clear so far? No? Okay. So, the reason we are checking this radial button is your policy, university's policy is non-commercial. What is this? This is bird, huh? Now, if you are using, I will tell you, first start with PPT. In the word, we will insert this in the footer. Please open a PPT. You are not following my instructions, sir. There, na? It's PPT. Oh, okay. Now, in the PPT, first you should get your title and your author and all this should be there. Oh, yes. Okay. That's the reason. Done? Shall we proceed? Yeah. Share alike means, say for example, if you are reusing the content with the share alike, you are supposed to release your remixed content also under the same license. You cannot add NC or ND or anything. Yeah. If you are reusing the content released under share alike SA, you cannot add NC or ND after remixing your own content. So, please remember that. There is a query on that. What is SA means? Okay, then. Shall we proceed? Just copy, where is that page you show us? After changing this to no, scroll down and copy only this part from this button and the text, and come back to your PPT and control Z, undo. So this is your blank PPT. No need to place your cursor anywhere, just control V, paste. So hold these two and drag down, that's it. Okay. And yeah, just go back to, again you all of you go to your chooser page, that is license chooser page. Scroll down. So here it says help others to attribute you. Yesterday we did an exercise, TASL format and everything. So we want to help others without doing all those attribution format and all. Please click here and add your title of your PPT. Click on this title of your work and your name, and if you have any pub URL on your, say for example, if you have a website or LinkedIn or anything, then automatically it will generate the attribution. This is second method. Please add your title of your work, that is PPT title, and your name. No. Generally, you create PPT for your lectures, no? So any title of one of your PPTs. This is only for practice purpose we are doing. That's it. Later, you can add your own PPT titles. Generally, you prepare for your class lectures, PPTs, no? So, one of those titles you please add here, and under author, that is attribute work to name, your name. And if you have any URL, and one more thing is, if you are taking source work URL, if you are taking anything from any source, any open textbook, that also you can provide here, otherwise not required. Done? If you have a blog also, you can add all these details. Scroll down. So now you got all these details with you. CC BY NC license with your title, presentation title and your name. Just copy this part again from the button to the license part. Come back to your PPT. Now you undo the first one, the first license that we attached, undo. And now control V. So you pull it down, that's it. Okay. So we will be helping others. No need to build that attribution and all. They can simply copy and paste when they reuse your work. If you have a readily available PPT, please add this license to that, so that I'll show you how to publish this on online platforms using the Creative Commons license. Do you have any readily available PPT? No? If you have any PPT, readily available PPT, please open that. We'll demonstrate how to publish on SlideShare and apply this license, CC BY NC license. You generally use for classroom teaching, no? PPTs. Please open one PPT. Good. Then you add this title on the title chooser, CC license chooser. This is the same license, of the PPT. So this PPT title is different or same? So then you go to license chooser and change it here. You can add this. The advantage of adding this is when you start recording all your lectures, it will be displayed on the first slide itself. The problem on YouTube is, as we discussed yesterday, YouTube CC BY license is only one license, whereas your university license is different. So we should make it visible on the first slide itself. Please remember that point. So open the PPT and change the title of that Creative Commons license chooser also. click on repair. Why? What's the problem? You go to downloads and check, you have two PPT, sir. No, no, this folder, third one, the toolbar, no, here. This one. Downloads, go to downloads and check. Downloads, and what's that? Lecture 2 is there, no? Open that? No, just double click and open. What's the problem? Oh, you need to download again, huh? Double click on that. Let it be. Are you? What's the problem in this? You don't have your PPTs on your pen drive? Yeah. One more, it's not there? You don't want this?
But I just transferred.
Yeah, then demo. Yes. You have two policies, open license policies. One is for MOOC and one is for.
But for smart PMS, we are following that one which is incorporated into the policy earlier. So we have not adopted.
You need to review and.
We need to go back. That's why in our system, right, Malaysian system, we need to take the policy to the Senate with that and then reference the document and then ask them to approve. And thus, until now, we have not done that.
Yes.
If I call, may ask her why it's not CCDY.
Okay. So have you checked that call agreement copy?
Yeah.
So is there anything they need to do on their course page?
It's not specific. The call agreement policy was the general policy, but then they have to develop specific guidelines.
Okay.
The policy was just the overall overarching policy.
Okay.
For specifics, like when we develop more for year, we have to make them specific guidelines.
In Triple IT Andhra Pradesh, we asked them to insert that block, HTML block with that CCBY SA. Then it was CCBY SA. Calls like CC license was CCBY SA. Okay then. So open, then you need to change the same title you have, then paste. Paste that CC license here. Just scroll up and change the title. Yes. Now you copy this updated license with the updated title. Come back to your PPT and Control V and pull it down. It's not visible, Anyways, then I think you need to remove that copyright. When you want to release, anyway, you are retaining your copyright. You are not giving away all the rights to others, but some rights you are reserving. If you want to use Creative Commons license, then you cannot use copyright on the sleeves. What happened? Undo. Yes. Redo. Okay, now your PPT is ready with a CC license, that is CCBY NC license. Do you have LinkedIn login account, I mean LinkedIn account, all of you? Are using any social media account, you can log in. Please, all of you go to slide share. Yeah, open a browser and go to slide share. And log in using either your LinkedIn or Facebook. Allow permissions. Sorry, login. Hi, oh, no, you can log in. You don't have a LinkedIn account. You forgot what happened. What does it say? You cannot use Facebook to log in. Oh, then you need to register. Yes. Yeah. Postal. You can create a postal or university from your university. Oh. Logged in? All of you? Yeah, come. Yeah, from there also. No, no, see, from here also you can give. Yeah, you can create. Yeah, both ways. But here. Yeah, everything. License, version, and everything. So this is the general practice, but we want to use the additional plugins available in Google Docs. That's the only difference. But yes. Yeah, please open your Google Doc. There is a query. So same, can I do Google Docs? This is yours? No. You are on the second browser. Go to Firefox, Google Docs. See, here the second add-on you have, click on add-ons. Here also you can generate the same using the Creative Commons license chooser. Start. So here you provide all these features. First select, no, commercial. So insert license information. You can simply add here on your Google Doc itself. So here it says down, can you see, read this, create based on creativecommons.org choose. He has taken the idea from creativecommons.org/choose. But whenever you want to insert this license on your Google slides, you can from here directly you can insert. Okay. Okay then. So all of us are on slide share now. Okay. Are you on slide share now? Then we have the button upload. Please click on that. You can simply drag and drop or click on the button select files to upload. And upload your PPT on which you have already applied your license. You didn't save, Ha ha ha. If no one complains, it's okay. If someone catches you, then Yeah. So here you need to see down, you can see discoverability score. Whenever you add some description, tags, and automatically this will increase. So you need to add description about your content of your PPT. What does it contain? It's processing. So in the meanwhile, you add. See the bottom this bar, it increases. Please, all of you add description category. Generally, this comes under education only. Yes. Now, LinkedIn was taken over by Microsoft. Microsoft, I think. I think LinkedIn is taken over by Microsoft. Yeah. And LinkedIn taken over Lynda. What is that? Lynda tutorials. So LinkedIn taken over Lynda tutorials. But they're working independently. Microsoft taken over this LinkedIn, but independently they're working. And choose category education. And privacy, leave it public only. The reason we are going to publish for others to reuse. Okay. No. Anyone, no. If you want to apply Creative Commons license, it should be under public only. Don't change that. And add tags. Tags means keywords. Whenever someone searches on SlideShare, so they can find it. That is the meaning of discoverability score. So you can add 10 tags also. No issue. Now, if you hit enter, automatically it will take. Do you still have problem with this? Yeah, click on the button upload. Have you added that CC license to your PPT? Yes. Then upload that and add all these. We call all these as metadata elements: category, privacy, tags, description. On sometimes you may find audience level also. This is my, is it meant for school children or higher education or UG and PG? We call all these as metadata. Please remember all these terms. These are useful for e-learning. You want to get full 100% discoverability score. Okay, yeah. Done? So, done adding all those metadata. Is this? Why? Yeah, you can later. Yeah. You can delete or you can hide. Or you can. Why you don't want to share? Okay, but you start preparing daily, na? So sit on that at least 3 or 4 hours. The reason, before I leave here, I want some percentage on the course. Okay, let's start. For practice purpose, huh? Yeah, do. Later we'll delete and we'll remove that. Okay. Okay. Then click on the button publish. So, anyway, we are recording this using Screencast-O-Matic. All these videos will be available with your e-learning center for future reference. Okay. So, we are done with publishing, but we need to apply your CC license, that is CC BY. For that, what you do is go to edit. Just below this PPT, you have edit button. Please click on that. And scroll down to license, that is by default it's all rights reserved. Yours is, where is non, yeah, CC attribution non-commercial license. Then update. whenever there is a query, change. If you want to change, you can change. Okay, change then. Whatever updates you want to do, you can edit here. And if you want to hide your slide, I mean this PPT, you have the second tab. Click on the privacy settings and make it private. But if you want to release as OERs, then it should be under public only, public mode only, not on privacy. No, privacy setting. Show them also the privacy settings. It's the second. No. Later we can see. Just to show them private. Click on the second. Oh, you need to save. Cancel then. First update then. I thought we can do all these under privacy settings. You can make it private. Some of you are doing this only for the practice purpose, so you can make it private so that no one can view it. Okay. Done. Not the same, why? Same only, na? Yeah, you need to. No, already published. Okay. So after publishing, you need to add here tags so that this score will increase. Yeah, discoverability score. So add tags. English communication, oral communication, something, business communication. What? No, with space, na? Tags. It's a two word, na? Yes. Hit enter, then you can add. Yeah, enter. You can add multiple. And here, description, okay. Why you should get the score increased, huh? Discoverability score. No. Then, you should make it public first. Then only you will get this score. Otherwise, you will not get. later you can change. Yeah. Click on publish. Then, can you just demonstrate again edit button? Just below the PPT, you have edit button. Click on edit. Yes. Scroll down to the license part. Now, you apply your university's license. That is NC non-commercial. Third one. Yes. Then, update. And if you want to hide it from the public, then under privacy settings, you have this. You can make it. Okay, we are done with this. And similarly, you can add this, insert the license, open your Google Drive PPT, no? One PPT, Google Drive, you were I think on Firefox, not here. Open your PPT on your Google Drive. Now, go to drive.google.com, no? Open it in a new tab, go to drive.google.com and open your PPT, one of your PPTs. On the PPT itself, you can insert using the second add-on. Open that, no? You have your lecture notes, PPTs are there, no? You don't have? So, on your Google Drive, you can open. Yeah, yesterday we forgot to learn how to embed PPTs from your repository, either from your Google Drive. Please, all of you open one of your PPTs on your Google Drive. We'll add a Creative Commons license and we'll embed on your course page. We'll learn that. Please open a PPT. Yes. Any PPT, this is only for practice purpose. And you need to open, if you want to embed this on your course page, first you need to open with, you need to open with Google Slides, then only we can embed that. on your Google Drive. So please open that with Google Slides. Yeah, click on that. Google Slides. Go to add-ons and check whether we have CC attribute. No, get add-ons. Yesterday we did on Google search for creative. Creative is more than enough. No need of comments. Yes. Where is that? Here we don't have. Why? Only on docs we have. Okay, then you need to get from Creative Commons license chooser only. We don't have that. Okay. But here our interest is how to embed this on our course page. Any Google Slide, you can embed your PPT either from by uploading to SlideShare or by using any external repository like Google Drive or OneDrive or Dropbox or Box. So what we are going to do is, we open this using Google Slides. Are you ready with your Google Slides? All of you, please open. Instead of uploading your PPTs on your course page and overloading your server, you can do this. Just use external repositories. On each repository, we have 5 GB space. Okay, open a PPT. This is only for practice purpose. Any PPT on your Google Drive. If you don't have, you upload your own PPT to Google Drive. Google Drive, on Google Drive, not here. Yeah. We are going to learn how to embed this on your course page. One PPT. You don't have a PPT, you can just drag and drop one PPT from your. That way also you can do. If you don't have any PPTs on your Google Drive, you just drag and drop your PPT to Google Drive. You can do that. It's very simple. Yeah. Drag and drop and open. And it will ask you to open it with Google. Where is that? Uploaded or not? I think that is the P is the one. Now it will ask you to open with Google.
Login and go to your course page. Similarly, I'll show you how to get the embed code from SlideShare also. Any SlideShare PPT you can embed on your course page. Copy the code and come back to your AMS training site. Fine, we don't have any controls.
Share
share button is there.
Mine.
Here also we can generate the embed code. Click on the button share on slide share, and if you scroll up, we have two options, either sharing this or embedding. Just copy this embed one and paste it. It's very simple. I personally prefer using the repositories only. The reason, whenever I do all my, I also install all this OneDrive and everything online. Whatever changes I do on this file, automatically all this will be reflected on the external repositories. Whereas in SlideShare, again, I need to update the file, delete this and update.